Now that you've completed all your paths, the next level that we're going to work on is recolorizing the image. So we need to first desaturate the image if you haven't already. Now this is really different than going to grayscale. So I want to make sure that you do it the right way. So follow these steps. Changing your image to grayscale would actually eliminate all the red, green, and blue channels. And so you just have a grayscale image, which then would not be able to be recolorized because there would be no channels to hold the red, green, and blue colorization. So what I'm going to do instead of going to grayscale is use an adjustment layer of hue and saturation and completely desaturate. Now, adjustment layers have been around for a long time, and they weren't located in this adjustment panel. So it may seem unfamiliar at first, but people have been using adjustment layers for a number of Photoshop versions. If you don't find adjustment layers, just go up into Window, Adjustment, and just bring out that panel. Hue and Saturation is located right here, and actually when you put your cursor over any of these icons, it will say the name of the adjustment layer. So I'm going to Hue and Saturation, and notice in my layers when I click on it that a new layer will show up called Hue and Saturation. Also, this area where the adjustment choices were, you now get the panel just for hue and saturation. And in this case, what I'm going to do is bring the slider down and completely desaturate the image to black and white. You'll see down here that hue and saturation is its own layer, and it comes with an automatic layer mask. Now this layer mask can be used just the way you've been using it. Let's say I wanted to get the brush and paint out part of this. I can paint with black and bring back the color in any area I wish to paint. In this case, though, we're just going to use this adjustment layer. I'm going to hit Command Z to go back one step. We're just using this adjustment layer to desaturate our background. And I'm also going to do a tricky little thing, which is called clipping. I'm actually going to clip this adjustment to this particular background layer. Think of it kind of like two pieces of paper. Your layers are two pieces of paper, and you're putting a paper clip around it so that basically the hue and saturation will be clipped to the background as if they're one document. And to do that, I'm going up here in the adjustment layer, and I'm clicking these. It looks like a black and white ring that are linked together. Once I click on that, take a look down here. You see this arrow, which points down to the background, and that means these are kind of paper clipped together. Now, right now, it's not making a whole heck of a lot of difference, but if I had quite a few layers underneath here, what would happen is adjustment layers are effects that I try to explain it like this, that an adjustment layer is like a water faucet. And if it's at the very top of the stack, that adjustment will trickle down to all the layers below. So literally, if I had 10 layers and I had this adjustment layer, it would desaturate all 10 layers, like it's a faucet dripping that effect all the way down the layers. So if I wanted it to only affect one layer, then I would clip it using this kind of paperclip technique to that one particular layer. So this is important to know in case you use adjustment layers. Let's say when you're doing retouch, you might want an adjustment layer to only affect one portion of the picture, which is contained on a layer. So now I want to get back to my adjustments, and so there's this little back button just like on a website, and when you click on that, that brings you right back to your choices. Now I'm ready for my paths. So I will bring in my paths, And I'm going to load one single path here.